excited today to be signing this memorandum of understanding with the National Park Service to be the repository for some truly important and valuable biological samples, those from threatened and endangered species from our U.S. national parks. These resources are really what's necessary for the kinds of biological studies to better understand the diversity of life on the planet, something that's been a central mission of the American Museum of Natural History since its inception.
All of the endangered foxes and butterflies are going to look like this. Mm-hmm. Every single one, they have a barcode on them, which gives it a unique identity. And we keep them in boxes with a map on top, mm-hmm. which seems very simple, but it's actually sort of a breakthrough in putting things in your freezer. So we can name this box one, put it in like rack two, it's in position 74, it's in this section, it's in that vat. It's in our computer database, so we can find the sample, any sample, in like 5 minutes and take it out.
The addition of this special collection greatly enhances both opportunities for this kind of research, as well as I think is a great example of a collaboration between a major scientific research institute, Natural History Museum, and this important element of the federal government.
This is hopefully one of many agreements that the Park Service will be signing with museums across the country. But this one is really important because of just the nature of the sensitivity of threatened and endangered species. I mean, if you just take the example of the island fox out of Channel Islands, how close we came to losing that animal. And if we lost that animal, we would have lost all that genetic information. And now with a facility like this, if some catastrophic event happens, and we happen to lose an animal or a species, at least we have some genetic material that we can understand what that species was about and how it related to its environment.